Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about graph data structure. Graph is an important data structure in computer science due to its innumerable application in real life scenarios. We unknowingly deal with them in our day-to-day life. We'll see few of their uses later on in this tutorial. Let's have a basic introduction of what graph is. By definition, graph represents a pairwise relationship amongst a set of objects. The component of graph is vertex, which are also called as nodes, edges, which are also called as arcs. The edges determine the relationship between pair of vertices. This diagram shows a basic graph with two vertices and an edge between them. Now we generally study graph into two categories, directed graph and undirected graph. These directed graph are also called as digraph and they are represented through a pair of ordered vertices. Ordered vertices means that the order of appearance of vertices in a set matters. That is, u, v is not equals to v, u. However, in an unordered set, this is not the case. Here, u, v and v, u both means the same. Let's quickly go through what undirected graph are. Undirected graph are represented through a pair of ordered vertices. You can see the difference between the two diagrams. In directed graph, we have an edge that is directional, whereas the undirected graph edge don't have a direction in it, which means that the relationship between these two vertices holds in both direction. Before jumping into complexities of what graph is, let's have some reasons to study them. We'll see few of the application of graphs. Graphs are used to represent a social network. In these networks, each person is represented with a node. These node contains information like person ID, name, his gender, his location, etc. And the edges are used to represent a relationship or a friendship. Graphs are also used to represent a road network. Consider a network of cities. If we say in terms of graph theory, these cities can be seen as vertices of a graph and the road used to connect them can be the edges. Precedent constraint problem refers to situation wherein there are certain prerequisites that need to be followed. An example for it could be in your college. Your college may issue constraint that in order to have course B, you need to pass course A, making it a prerequisite for course B. Now we will see how to represent a graph. We basically have two methods to represent a graph. The first method is using an adjacency matrix and the other method is an adjacency list. Beside these two, we also have other representation as an incidence matrix and incidence list. Let's see what an adjacency matrix is. By definition, an adjacency matrix is a 2D matrix of size V cross V with zeros and 1. Note that V here refers to number of vertex a graph has. So if we say that an entry in ith row and jth column is 1, means that there is an edge between 0 and 1. We will see adjacency matrix with the help of an example. Consider the graph as shown here. This graph is undirected and have 5 vertex numbered 0 to 4. These edges determines that these vertex are connected. Now corresponding adjacency matrix will be like this. Let's consider few entries. We have 1 for row number 1 and column number 0. Since this is an undirected graph, there will also be 1 at row number 0 and column number 1. See how the nodes 0 and 1 are connected. Similarly, we have 1 at row number 3 and column number 2, which means we will also have 1 at row number 2 and column number 3. All the zeros in the matrix means that there is no connection between the two vertices. We have a 0 at row number 2 and column number 4, which means that vertex number 2 and vertex number 4 are not connected. This can be easily seen from the graph. Now we make few observations. Notice how all the diagonal elements are 0. What does this mean? It means that a graph do not contain any self loop. Again, notice how our adjacency matrix is a symmetric matrix. Will it always be true? The answer is no. This will be true only when we have an undirected graph. Now for a weighted graph where there is some weight associated with each edge, we can replace these ones with the weight of the edge. We now see the advantages that we have in using an adjacency matrix. The first advantage we have is that adjacency matrix are easy to implement. All we need is a V cross V matrix. The second advantage is that removing an edge will cost us big O of 1 complexity. For removing an edge, we just need to make the corresponding entry in our adjacency matrix from 0 to 1. The other advantage is that queries wherein we need to know if certain edge exists or not can be done in O1 time. We just need to check if corresponding entry is 0 or 1. With the view that nothing is perfect, let's also care to look at few disadvantages we have with matrix representation. It requires more space. We need to have big O of V square space to store all the possible edge results. One more disadvantage is that addition of a new vertex will cost big O of V square. This is because we need to update result of all the previous vertices with this new vertex. We are done with adjacency matrix now. Let's have a look at another representation, which is known as adjacency list. Now, as the name suggests, adjacency list uses an array of linked lists to store a graph. Each index of array corresponds to a node in a graph, and the list attached with this index are its neighbor nodes. We will see adjacency list with the help of an example. Consider the graph we have worked on previously. The corresponding adjacency list will be like this. Let's see what it means. This is an array of vertices. Index 0 corresponds to vertex 0. Now we can see that node 0 has its edge with 1 and 4. Yes, it has. Node 1 has its edge with 0, 4, 2, and 3. Similarly, for node 2, 3, and 4. This, as we can guess, is more efficient representation. Let's quickly see advantages of an adjacency list. It saves space. Definitely true. This is because we store only the pair that are connected with an edge, unlike an adjacency matrix where we fill a 0 if a pair is not connected by an edge. Note that maximum space will be required when each vertex is connected to all the other vertices. The other advantage is that addition of a new vertex is easy. This is because a new vertex means a new entry in our array, and therefore we just update the new edge with this new entry. Now the disadvantage with these adjacency lists is when we need to find if there is an edge between two vertices. This operation will cost big O of V complexity, unlike adjacency matrix where it can be done in big O of 1 time. Here is a snapshot of how to implement an adjacency list version of a graph. You can go through this code given on GeeksforGeeks, which is quite simple and self-explanatory. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. For any doubt or queries, do leave your comments. Thanks for watching.